Mr. Milland, for how many years do you think cider has been made on your farm?
Well, I would say it must be at least 150 years, I would say. I would think so, or getting up to that number of years.
Presumably it was made here by your father and grandfather?
Yes, certainly they both made ciders, and it was always drunk on the farm, you see.
I shouldn't think there are very many farms today, certainly not in Gloucestershire, where one can see cider being made by the real old-fashioned method.
No, I think not. I think they've mainly died out. And, of course, the cider isn't drunk on the farm. It's the same as it used to be years ago.
How old do you think this mill of yours is here?
Well, I would think it was probably built sometime between, 1830 and 1850, I would think, as far as we know. But, of course, we've got no records, so we can't really say for certain.
Well, the noises we can hear in the background consist mainly of the horse walking round with the mill. Would you like to describe how it works?
Well, we put the fruit in... The mill is a trough, and a circular trough, and the horse is geared in there. The wheel goes round in the trough, and it pulps the pears or apples or whatever you have in the mill, you see. That is the whole purpose of it, but it's rather difficult to explain, really.
Well, after the pears or apples have been squashed in the trough, you then bale them out, and what's the next thing after that?
What we do, we build a cheese, what we call a cheese. What we use is coconut matting. We have 9 coconut mats, and we put about, say, 7 buckets of pulp in each mat, and fold each mat over and put the next mat on top of the lower mat until we've got the 9 mats in what we call a cheese. And then after we've built a cheese, we have to press it down. We put blocks on, and then we press it down between 2 screws. The juice comes out into a trough at the lower part of the press, and then we ladle the cider from the trough into barrels, and the barrels, they ferment, the cider ferments in the barrels, and it's generally fit to drink, we'll say, in 3 or 4 months' time.
So there's no sort of straining or purification, it just goes straight into the barrels?
No, there's no purification whatsoever. What we do find, there's quite an amount of sediment in the bottom of the barrel after the cider has been taken out, which we call the grounds, you see.
What sort of fruit are you using at the moment?
They're Blakeney Red pears. Of course, we're making perry this morning. We haven't any real cider apples. When we do grind any apples, it's generally either cooking apples or anything we can find. And we find that it rather helps to blend the cider if we've got a variety of fruit in one barrel. It does help it.
Well, presumably different kinds of cider fruit make very different kinds of cider.
Oh yes, some is sharper and some rather sweeter, but I think most people would find the farm cider quite rough compared with what you would buy in bottles or in the ordinary sweet brewery cider.
Do you drink very much of your own cider?
Well, I drink a fair drop, but I don't sort of sit and drink it. I work and drink. I come in, say, in the morning and have, a half a pint, and then go out again for an hour and come in and have another half pint. And so I during the day, I do drink a fair drop when it, is all reckoned up. But it's rather different sort of working and drinking and sitting and drinking it. I think I would soon get a little bit tipply if I, sat there and I should soon get under the barrel, I believe.
Your horse seems to do his job and know his job extremely well. Is he very old?
Oh, yes. I understand he's 25 years old. He's not my horse. He's a horse that someone kindly lets us have for the cider making. And he's quite good at his job now.
Did it take you very long to break him into the mill?
Well, no, not too long. But there's always... I have to be very careful at the start. just to put a small amount of fruit in the mill when you start, so that the mill doesn't bluff, or are there any obstacles that he doesn't like? And once he's sort of got his confidence, he seems to go around quite well.
I wish it were possible to record smells, Mr. Milan, because the smell is really beautiful in this cider house.
Oh, yes, it is. It's wonderful. People who come to the farm, they soon know that we're cider making. They can smell the fruit.